I'll also show you how to do the magic trick. It involves this sheet of newspaper here, and it's called the Torn and Restored Newspaper. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to tear the newspaper. Pieces. Okay. Oh. Now I just have this big wad of newspaper, and I just simply begin putting in my palm for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Take it out. And you can now see that the newspaper has completely restored itself to its original shape. And now I will show you how to do that trick. Okay, now how I did the torn and restored paper. For this sake of demonstration on how to do it, I'm gonna be using two very different newspapers. And for your information, this trick does involve using two sheets of paper, if you already guessed that. I will try and find newspaper that looks like this, with just all writing on it. That's kind of like what you want, because it's easy to find two pages that look exactly alike, because they're all just covered in writing. So you're going to want something that looks the same, but for this demonstration, like I said, I have two ones that look very different. What you're going to want to do is, this is done before the trick, you're going to want to take a sheet of paper, crumple it up into the tightest ball you can get it. And then what you're going to do is, right before you start the trick, you're going to take it and place it behind the sheet of paper that you're going to be doing the trick with, like this. And then you're going to want to hold it like this. But from the front view, it's being held in this hand right here, one that I'm moving. It looks like you just have one sheet, but if you ever see an exposed view, you can see you have that wad of paper back there. So now you have that all set up. Now what you do is you begin tearing the paper. And then the most important thing is that when you tear it, put it in front of the paper, not behind, because that'll ruin the trick, because it'll cover up that wad of crumpled up paper you have there. So put it in front. And you just keep doing this until left with a little sheet of paper. And you might find it a little challenging to rip paper while holding that ball, but it's, once you get used to it, it's not too hard. You can't rip it. I'm just going to leave it at that. But you'd want to rip it more. But what you're going to want to do then is you take all this here, and you don't want to fold it, like to fold it, to crinkle it up in a way. You don't want to fold it back, because you'll cover up that ball of paper. You want to fold it forward, like that. Just kind of bring it all forward until it's about the same size as that ball. And kind of crinkle it up around it. And now here's this little move that usually the audience won't see, is as you're crinkling it up, you bring it forward so that the ripped sheet of paper is in the back facing you, and the restored sheet, or the full sheet of paper, is facing them. But if you just hold it like this, it really, you can't tell the difference that there's two different balls there, and paper balls there, sorry. So once you're like this, you can do a little dramatic effect, put it in your palm, close it, snap, 1, 2, 3, it's restored itself, whatever. Or you can just again. But then you're just going to fold up, making sure to keep that this wad of torn paper behind it, and just kind of maneuver it around. This is an exposed view, by the way. Just kind of go like this, and just kind of fold it, unfold it like that. Show them that it's completely restored, and then don't give it to them to look at, because it'd be kind of hard to get rid of this wad of paper. So a great way to end the trick is just crinkle it up and throw it away.